I have a saying, many of you who watch the show, you know, you hear me use it a lot, Almighty God has a way of allowing good people to cross each other's path. And those of us that truly cherish good friendship of good godly people, we hold on to that for dear life. And there are some who abuse it, take advantage, and they no longer have that connection with people that really came to befriend them. I try to hold on, and I do cherish each and every one of them. And Miss Danette Butler is one who I cherish, one whose friendship I cherish. She's one that I consider to be Herman's angels. I used that phrase going back some time ago during the elections with she and Josie Roy and Wanda and Sandy Anderson and Jackie Wright and some others. And because they were just so dedicated in anything that I needed them to do, Sharon Briscoe, they were there, and always ready and willing to help. So I just cherish that, Danette. I appreciate the support ongoing of your family, your grandmother, who passed just a little bit ago, your beautiful mother, and all the family that have supported both me and my dad, Senator Holloway, over the years, and Al Plant and Scotty and some of the others, right there on the firing line, ready to hit the street and go try to get every vote that you can. So I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You're truly indeed a friend, and I plan to continue to support you, and the good Lord willing, we go there next year. I'm gonna be there an hour ahead of time and sit out in the car and catnap or something so that I don't mess up two times in a row. Say that, thank you very, very much. Folks, we're gonna take a short break, going out at Osborne and to King Center, that billboard there, advertisement, wanna keep that before you. Talk about that a little bit when I come back. Gonna take a short break, please stay tuned.
Osborne's Auto Repair, serving downtown Wilmington for 30 years. Delaware State certified in auto emissions. We do tune-ups, brakes, air conditioning, all car needs. Stop in and see Ed Osborne or his son, Ed Osborne Jr. That's Osborne's Auto Repair, 658-0377, or visit us on the web at osbornsauto.com. Stop in and see Osborne's.
Billboard campaign in the city of Wilmington promoting a confidential telephone number 888-1800 to help stop the violence in Wilmington sincerely needs your help. This anonymous call will not show your name or telephone number, so be a part of it all. Make the call to report any information that may solve a violent crime or prevent one. Remember, we are all in this together. Help our residents feel safe again in their homes and in their communities. Help to get the illegal guns off our city streets. Innocent people are getting shot and killed. Who will be next? Make the call. 888-1800. Sponsored by the King Center.
Right on.
Okay, back for the program here, second part. And let me just say that I'm going to be taking some regular breaks here at 6:35 and then at the close, because I got some promos and some things that I got to keep before you. I want to ask if Mike or Shanna are listening in listening range of this program. I'll see them maybe after my show goes off at 7. I want to ask them in the upper room if they would play the billboard promo a couple different times. It's only a minute, 2-3 seconds long. And if they would play it a couple times, as well as I want to ask Sammy on the Congo Hour, he and Raina, if they would, and Trippy, if they would play it a couple times, and Norman Oliver as well. I plan to leave a copy of that promo, the billboard campaign, down here. And Aubin will have it, and hopefully, again, each of these three programs will play that at least a couple times while they're on the air for their hour. Why do I ask them to do that? And again, what is the billboard campaign? As you've seen, the billboard campaign, and some of them are up now, and I think it's 4 of them up, and we got 2 more going up next week, and they're going to be scattered and whatnot, and they're very bright colored. The billboard that you see in the promo that I just played is the billboard that is up, and now you see as you move about the city. 888-1800. I had a long talk about a week ago with Pastor Beeman and with a lot of you. I've also, on last Thursday or Friday I think it was, I did an email blast to everyone who was in our email at the King Center. And what I did there, number one, was to explain the billboard campaign and its purpose, which, as you can see, it's to encourage confidential phone calls into that number. Nobody's name, nobody's phone number, address will appear on the board in the 911 center when you call in if you use that number. We want to encourage through the churches, through the pastors, through word of mouth, and please share this with family members and friends at your workplace or whatever if you're in the city, because we must realize that everybody does not have Comcast cable. So please let them know and make it a conversation piece to remember. Call up your friends and neighbors. This is a phone number, 888-1800, that will allow anonymous phone calls for any important information that may lead to a shooting and or may lead to the prevention of a shooting. If we, the leadership working together in unity, can get the entire community to step in, to become interested and want to make a call and be a part of it all. That's a phrase that Ed Osborne put together. It's kind of catchy. Be a part of it all, make the call, 888-1800. Help to stop the crime and violence in our community. There it is up on the board there. And again, this is so very, very, very important. My shows every week now will be pumping these promos. And as you see the billboards going up in my conversation, the majority of my show is going to be dealing with the importance of helping you to understand why we need you to get involved. The mayor, the police department cannot do it alone. They need the citizens' help and input. And I encourage you to use this if you hear and know of anything in passing, however you get the info. Please pass it on, because you could be saving someone's life. I read in the paper this morning where a young man was shot in the leg on Friday evening out around, I think it was, North Monroe Street. They're innocent people getting shot that aren't even a part of any of this drug epidemic in our community. The little 5-year-old girl a few weeks ago that caught a bullet in the arm. You know, the problem that we have is there are far too many guns on the streets. Our police need to be about the business to try to come up with every strategy they can to really get a handle on these shootings, violence, and murder. And again, my folks, they need our help, we the citizens. So I appeal to you to put the word around, 888-1800, as you're riding in and around the city, you see the big, beautiful colored billboard, and you see that number, I ask that you pass it on and try to remember it. Lock it in your subconscious, 888-1800. Don't put yourself in harm's way. You see something look like it's getting ready to go down or whatever. Continue on your journey, get out of the way. Do not put yourself in harm's way. But after you do that, use your cell phone and put a call through right away and tell them of what you have seen, witnessed, or heard, that they may be able to dispatch a car and get on top of it so that hopefully, we can stop another shootout. We could stop another shooting and or murder in our community. This is something that I am totally committed to. I'm calling on all my friends in leadership. I've talked with many of them and asked them to do two things. One, to really put the word around, and I'm going to be asking my clergy friends to seriously consider putting a short sentence about this and how important it is that the citizens get involved in their church booklet and with the anonymous phone number, 888-1800. And I would hope that they would not have a problem or feel it would be a problem with that. Secondly, I'm going to appeal to Mayor Williams to appoint again the community board that met regularly with the Wilmington Police Department every other month under the leadership of Barbara Washam. We need to go back to that because it helped to have better community police relations. We could tell them things that we hear or things the way that we witnessed or the way things went down that may have handled a little differently, would have had a more calm kind of reaction or something. And they get to share with us the things that they would like to share, that they say, can we please, out in the community, be of help to them. On that board, as I said, I was a member that was representative of people all over the city, young, old, black and white, from northeast, south and west, and northwest, up on the hill, the valley, Madison Street, people all over the city. And we had a very good committee meeting every other month, and at time of crisis, we were called by the chairperson, and we would have called meetings, emergency meetings. So they're very important, and it's a lot of other things that I will be sharing and asking the community, the leadership, to unite and to go to work on. I plan to organize a luncheon, and I'll give ample notice because I realize everybody is busy, the people that I want at the table. So I want to try to make sure that they can put it on their calendar and be present. And I will invite them in to a luncheon. And my luncheon will be dealing with ways that we need to unite and connect together and strategies on how we're going to address a lot of these ongoing problems. I happen to believe that the problems of our communities are like a tree with many branches. No one solution is going to help solve that problem. It's just not going to happen. And we have to take a look at each problem.